Hi everyone, my name is Anna and welcome to Cactus Caffeine, where I share with you my passion of growing cactus and other desert plants over a cup of coffee. So it is time to make an update, guys, on this PC Cooler Grow Light that I received a month ago. So it has been 1 month since I've been using this grow light over my aloes right here. So I am in my garage, so I have a different kinds of plants growing in here under different grow lights, but these aloes are the ones that are directly under this PC Cooler grow light. So after 1 month, I would say I was surprisingly pleased with this grow light. Yes, I was surprised because this light actually looks very interesting. it looks different than the other grow lights that I am used to seeing. So first and foremost, it has that metal plate at the back, and then also under the light there is actually a glass that covers those LED lights for protection. But then I realized this metal case right here, it's actually aluminum. It actually serves a purpose of dissipating the heat, because look, it has been on for several hours now, but it doesn't get hot at all. I can still touch the back, the metal plate. It doesn't get hot at all. So that is the purpose of that metal or aluminum plate, is to dissipate the heat. And likewise, the glass covering underneath this light or over the LED bulbs serves the purpose of protecting them from dust and also from splashes of water when you're watering your plants. Now, as for the aloes that I have growing under this light, I am also very much satisfied because this light was able to bring them out of their dormancy or summer dormancy and make them grow. If you remember when I unboxed this light and I first placed the aloes in here, most of them have leaves that were curled or closed because they were still summer dormant. But right now, all of them, or most of them, have widely open leaves, and there's so much growth in some of them. Like this one is aloe lizard lips. Look, it is in flower. There's a lot of flower stalks. This tall one has been there when I first placed it here, but all the other flower stalks, those are all new, and they just came out after I moved them here in the garage. This is the flower of this aloe blizzard, and this flower just developed within the 1 month that this is under this grow light. So that's aloe blizzard, very pretty. And I'm also very pleased that it was able to bring out, this light was able to bring out the colors or distressed colors on some of the aloes. So it is not very clear if I show it to you right here, because the grow light has the tendency to mess up the colors in the camera, but it does have that stress color in them. So I'm just going to show you a picture of some of the aloes right here outside. I will bring them outside under the sun so you can see the colors properly. But yeah, I am very, very pleased at how my aloes are reacting to this light. So especially this aloe oik, I just love how the color changed on this one. Then this is the aloe snowstorm. This used to be right underneath the light, but I don't like this when it's stressed, because this aloe has a tendency to change its color to brown when stressed instead of red or pink. So I moved it farther away from the light so it could revert back to its green and white color. You might be hearing a sound of a fan in the background. That is actually coming from my other grow light here. This one has a fan, but this PC cooler, it is very quiet because it doesn't come with a fan. I have this light set up about 18 inches on top of the aloe. Between, I would say between 12 to 18 inches, depending on how tall the aloe is. So that's how I have this light set up, and it is turned on for 6 hours a day. Now, every growth that happened on this aloe, I can attribute it only to this light because my garage doesn't have any windows in it. So there's no sunlight that comes in here in the garage at all. If I turn on this grow light, my garage is in complete darkness. So all the light that my plants receive here in my garage is actually just from the grow lights. So whatever growth or whatever developments that you see out of these plants are purely the work of the grow lights. The only thing I can probably say against this light is its weight. So it is heavier than the other grow lights that are out in the market. But then, you know, you'll only be dealing with the weight when you're hanging the light. But once it's hang and all set up, you don't actually have to worry about the weight. And also, it would be probably be better if this has a dimmer or a dimming function, because most of the grow lights now, the newer models, have a dimming function. So maybe if PC Cooler will be coming out with another model of grow light, they will have that dimming function already. This one obviously is not an aloe. This is a string of dolphin. So I placed it here because I wanted to test how powerful this grow light would be. So these were cuttings. When I placed it in here, they were cuttings that I was rooting. Well, I rooted them in water, so they already had roots when I placed it in here. But since then, after a month, it actually produced new branches. So this is new, this long one is new, and as well as this one at the bottom is also new stems that grew from the original cuttings that I have here. Now, I use this string of dolphins to test this light as well, because string of dolphins are very notorious for losing their shape when they don't get enough sunlight. But as you can see, the new growth here, they all have that dolphin shape still. So that means this light is very efficient, actually. So the fact that it was able to maintain the shape of these dolphins means this light is giving out just enough light for them to maintain their shape but not burn. And also at the very end, as you can see, it is also starting to develop a flower. And so this is it for my update for this PC Cooler grow light. If you're interested to purchase this light, I will have a link at the bottom of this video, so it is available through Amazon. All right, so if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you like cactus, aloes, and other desert plants. So until next time again, bye guys, and cheers.